Hello everyone, my name is Prasad Desai and I welcome you to the first ever podcast episode of the series Man Behind the Money. The idea of this podcast series is to understand the behavioral traits that go into place in order to make a financially successful human being, especially in the world of money management and business. A lot has been discussed about the methods to do financial analysis in my other videos. So, I have dedicated this series to the behavioral aspects of finance. The game of money is played 50% with skills and rest 50% with discipline. It becomes then important that we understand and ingrain the behavioral traits necessary to be successful financially. I'm not really sure how many such episodes I'll make in this series, but it is more of an experimental idea that was flirting at the back of my mind to do a podcast. So I have started with this series. Today's topic of discussion is investing in yourself. I constantly see people rise in life who are not the smartest. Sometimes not even the most diligent, but they are a continuous learning machine. In his 2007 University of Southern California School of Law speech, Charlie Munger said that lifelong learning is paramount to long-term success. If you take Berkshire Hathaway, which is certainly one of the best regarded corporations in the world, the skill that got Berkshire through one decade would not have sufficed to get it through the next decade without Warren Buffett being a continuous learning machine. Most people go through life not really getting any smarter, but you can acquire wisdom if you truly want to obtain it. In fact, a simple formula, if followed, is almost certain to make you smarter over time. It's simple but not easy. It involves a lot of hard work, patience, discipline, and focus. Self-improvement is the ultimate form of investing in oneself. It requires devoting time, money, attention, and hard effort now for a payoff later, sometimes in the far distant future. A lot of people who are unwilling to make this trade-off because they crave instant gratification and desire instant results. These short-term costs, when applied the right way along an axis of time, offer an exponential payoff when applied over a long life. Reading 500 pages a day might not be feasible for you. If, however, you can find ways to read during your day, at night or on the weekends, you're likely to see multiple benefits. Start with reading 25 pages a day or 20 pages a day and make it a habit. Reading is also linked with higher emotional intelligence, reduced stress, a wider vocabulary, and improved comprehension. If you think of your mind as a library, three things should concern you. 1. The accuracy and relevance of the information you store. 2. Your ability to find or retrieve the information on demand. And 3. Your ability to put information to use when you need it. That is, your ability to apply the knowledge that you have learned in practical life scenarios. Reading is one of the ways to acquire knowledge, but it is not the only way. You can listen to podcasts like this, you can watch YouTube videos, and there are other methods of knowledge consumption that might fit your cup of tea and you can ingrain them in your daily habits. But it is very vital that you should be careful of what you take in. I personally like reading. What many people see as a 300 page book is often the accumulation of thousands of hours of work. Where else can you get the entire life's work of someone in the space of few hours? If you look at the most talented people in any given field, may it be sports, money management, acting, business, most of these people are self-educated. Self-improvement is the best way to spend some of your time every day. But most people find it difficult to remove the time required to read and get smarter. One way to make this happen is to carve out a dedicated 1 hour in the day just for yourself. If you need inspiration, consider how you could sell this hour of your day to yourself. Tell yourself that you are the most valuable client of your own business, and if you were to dedicate and invest 1 hour of a day in yourself, improving and reading and getting better, your skill sets will eventually go up, making you much more richer and better over time. It is essential to understand the opportunity cost of this 1 hour. On one hand, you can indulge in getting quick dopamine hits from social media and emails. Or on the other hand, you can dedicate the time to deep work and self-improvement. An hour's time spent acquiring in-depth knowledge about an important principle pays off in the long run. This current investment is minuscule compared with the significant amount of returns that you will get over a lifetime. Time is a resource that becomes increasingly scarce for everyone with each passing second. Learn to value your time highly. No matter how much money you have, you can't buy more time. We each have only 24 hours available to us every day. Time is the currency of life that appreciates in value the more it's spent. Minimize your commute time to work. Outsource all the non-core, time-consuming, menial tasks to free up valuable time for self-development. The extra money spent on these small luxuries will pinch you initially, but over time, you'll realize that it was well worth it. In the long term, the daily investment in learning something new and improving yourself goes a long way. So the best investment of time is to invest in personal development. I hope the time you are investing in reading, learning new skills, or listening to this podcast today yields positive results for the rest of your life. I can happily say that I'm a better investor because I'm a lifelong learner, and I'm a better lifelong learner because I'm an investor. It seems fitting to end this podcast episode with one of my favorite quotes from Benjamin Franklin: an investment in knowledge pays the best interest. Thank you so much for listening to this podcast episode. I hope to see you in the next one.